That's the reason why we moderate everything, so that by the grace of God, when the trumpet shall sound and the saints go marching in, by the grace of God, preaching will not tie me down. I will not be like Jehu. I will not be like Gideon. I'll not be like Solomon. As I'm preparing other people, I'm getting prepared. I'll go there too. Somebody there, are you getting there? Are you getting the point I'm making this day? Because that's what the Lord is telling us. He said, what will it be if we gain all the, you know, we gain all the souls and win all the souls? And he said, praise the Lord. Our GS is energetic at his age. You know, he preaches, he's just finished the Congress now. We hear that he's also in Japan. He has gone to China and then he rushes back on Saturday. And he's there at the combined service and the man is still fresh. Wonderful. That is not wonderful. The man, you don't want to kill the man internally, spiritually. You want him to have some little time. I will not be like this Solomon. Say it for yourself. I will not be like Jehu. I will not be like Gideon. Balance up everything in your life. This year is a year of balance. And this year the word of God will work mightily in our lives in Jesus' name. And if we try to help you and we say, cut it down, cut those activities down, cut it down, cut those committee meetings down, don't grudge us. I'm trying to help you to get to heaven. You will get there. I say, don't belong to two committees at the same time. Let this person do it. Other people, are, look at these thousands of people. We have many of them fitting this one here, this one there, this one there. Lessen your own load. Shed the load and give it to other people so that all of us can bear the load together. And eventually, every one of us, the people I see here today, look up at me here, we're going to get to heaven together. I'm looking at point number three now, spiritual profit and progress of new Bible believing pilgrims, spiritual profit and progress of Bible believing Christians. We will make it. We're looking at First Timothy. We're reading from chapter 4 and verse 8. First Timothy chapter 4, and we're looking at verse 8. First Timothy chapter 4, and we're looking at verse 8. It tells us in chapter 4, verse 8, it says, for bodily exercise profited little, but godliness is profitable unto all things, having the promise of the life that now is and of that which is to come. Having the promise of the life which is now is and of that which is to come. Then it tells us in verse 15 and verse 16, it says, meditate upon these things. We don't have time to meditate because meditation takes time. That meditate upon these things and give thyself wholly unto them, wholly unto the word of God, the word that saves and the word that sanctifies and the word that strengthens and empowers you. Give yourself to that, that your profiting may appear unto all. Stop there for a moment. Your profiting may appear unto all. Look up here for a moment now. You see, sometimes you've gone through the retreat, and after the retreat, people say, this is the best retreat I've ever attended since I've been in Deep Alert. Readiness for the coming of Christ, readiness for a second coming. And then after that, we go for Congress. And then the people say, Congress? 1 Corinthians chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. I never saw it like this before. But then 2 days after all that, the same kind of life that we're living before the retreat, before the Congress, we resume the same old life. That your wife is saying, my husband, I don't want to be rude. My husband, I don't want to say anything that goes wrong direction. But where is the result of the Congress you spoke about? You told me, it's not 1 week yet. Just a few days ago, you told me, this is the best Congress I attended in my life. But the way you were treating me the old year, that's the way you are treating me now. I'm just like, you know, doormat. There's no respect for woman, for wife, in our house here. Anything you want to say, you never think that it hurts. My husband, look at the way you're doing. And you say that that Congress was, it was great, it was classical, it was spiritual, it was this, it was that. Where is the prophet? You see, even though we hear it in our ears, the prophet is not seen. Because immediately after, even during that congress, we're busy here, we're busy there, we're busy there. And because of being busy and busy and busy, we cannot see the result. That's why it's saying that thy profiting may appear unto all. Things must change. I said things must change. You go to your office and the same dummy things were doing in your office, the same thing you're still doing, the same way you talk, the same way you act, the same attitude you had, and the same kind of selfishness and self-centeredness is still what is there. There is no change. That's why it's saying, meditate on this word, all that we're hearing, so that this year we're going to make progress. And then we'll say, that's a pilgrim, it's a renewed pilgrim, that's a pilgrim, it's a nourished pilgrim, that's a pilgrim, it's not a negligent pilgrim. Look at verse 16, take heed to thyself and unto the doctrine. Continue in them, for in doing this thou shalt both save thyself and them that hear thee. It's not just enough to hear the word of God. You must process it, internalize it, personalize it, and say, this is me and this is mine. It will be yours in Jesus' name. We're looking at Hebrews chapter 4. I'm looking at verse 1. It says, let us therefore fear, lest the promise being left us of entering into his rest, any of you should seem to come short of it. Lest any of you should seem to come short of it. Look at verse 2. For unto us was the gospel preached, as well as unto them. But the word preached did not mix, did not profit them. The word preached did not profit them. Because why? Not being mixed with faith in them that heard that gospel, that heard the word. Can you think of people that heard the word and the word did not profit them? I can think of some. Achan had all the instructions that Joshua gave out when they were to go to that battlefield. The word did not profit him. He had something else on his mind. And because of what he had on his mind, that word that Joshua preached did not help him. He said, when I saw the wedge of gold and the goodly Babylonian garment, and then I coveted and took and hid it in my tent. And you think of Ahab. Ahab had all the words of Elijah. Elijah said, see, the Lord has sent me to you. And he gave him the message. The word did not profit him. Why? Because his wife was a strong influence on him. That man sold himself to do evil because of his wife. How about Balaam? Balaam had the word of God. Balaam saw an angel, and Balaam saw the angel with a sword in the hand. The word he heard from the angel did not profit him. Why? Because of covetousness. That thing was still in the heart. Covetousness ate him up. Hey, but Lot's wife, the word that Lot's wife heard did not profit her. Why? Angels came, laid hold on them and said, escape to the mountain. This city is going to be destroyed. But the word that woman had did not profit her because of worldliness. Korah, Dathan, and Abiram. Moses spoke the word of God to them. Are you seeking the priesthood? Look at this. See what the Lord has given us. The Lord is leading us from the land of Egypt unto the promised land. Are you seeking the priesthood also? Korah did not listen, and the ground opened up and just swallowed them up. How about Jezebel? That woman was power drunk. Power drunk. You know, if you are power drunk, you want to be in control. You want to be in charge. You want to not only control, you know, your husband. You want to control Elijah. Control the nation and tell your Ahab what Ahab has to do. The woman was power drunk. All the word that she heard did not profit her. And then think about Judas Iscariot of all people. Every message Jesus gave, every miracle Jesus performed, every parable that Jesus told, Judas has got heard everything. And he was not just an ordinary member of the team. He was the treasurer. He was a bank carrier. And he could, you know, dip his hand there and pay this out and pay this out. Even the one that he wasn't supposed to pay out, he did all that. But everything here, he even had a personal word. One of you is going to betray me. Am I? And Judas has got said, Is it me? And Jesus said, yes, you are. I'm going to dip this in food. I'm going to put it in the mouth of the betrayer. He put it in his mouth. That did not change him. The words he heard did not profit him, because he did not mix with faith in his heart. And Demas, because of friendship with the world, Demas had all those messages of Paul the apostle. Did not profit him. He still went to Circa, and then he went into the world. How about you? What you have been hearing, has it profited you? Are you making up your mind that this year will be different? This salvation that we have been emphasizing, and the peace of God in our heart, and whosoever is born of God does not commit sin, this one, I'm going to take it to heart this year. What other assignment do you have that is greater than watching over your soul? What other assignment do you have that is greater than keeping your soul for heaven? What other assignment have you given yourself? What assignment has somebody given you that is greater than getting saved, getting sanctified, and possessing this peace of God and holiness without which no man shall see the Lord? What do you think is better than salvation, better than sanctification? What do you do in the church? What responsibility do you have in the church? The one we gave you, the one we didn't give you, that is so important to you, more than you're getting to heaven. How wise are you? Are you a pilgrim? Are you a wise pilgrim? Are you going to get to heaven, or have you lost your sense of direction completely? I pray that this day you'll get it back in Jesus' name. We're looking at Mark chapter 8. Mark chapter 8. Here I'm reading from verse 37. Why don't you back up to verse 36? Mark chapter 8, verse 36. For what shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? What shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? This day, the Lord is calling us to wisdom. We're going to be wise. If you are backsliding, you'll come back and say, Lord, now I mean business. This heaven, I will get to heaven. Hell, I've heard about hell. Jesus spoke about hell. It's a place where fire is burning. It will be forever and ever. Once anybody gets in there, no way, he'll never come out. He'll be forever there, suffering and burning. I've heard of heaven. And Jesus spoke of heaven. And there's glory there. There's joy there. There's no thirst there. There's no need there. And those who are there are happy and joyful forever and ever. And once endure all the temptation, all the trial, whatever may be happening here on earth, once you get to heaven, you are there forever and ever. You'll forget your sorrows. You'll forget your tears. You'll forget your heartaches. You'll forget all the problems you had here on earth. That heaven, I will get there. That heaven, you will get there. You want to rise and tell the Lord, rise up and tell the Lord that day, from this day, you want to be wise. From this day, you want to be a pilgrim that says I'm focused, a pilgrim that says I'm fiery, a pilgrim that says I'm facing the direction of my travel. I want to get to heaven. I want to get to heaven. Let this word mix with faith in your heart. Let this peace of God be there. Make sure you're saved. Let this purity be there. Make sure you're sanctified. And then if you're saved and sanctified, the power of the Holy Ghost available this morning, and it will fill you with the Holy Ghost. You have baptized the Holy Ghost before. Why don't you plunge yourself again into the ocean of the Spirit of God, so that all the power you need, all the strength you need, everything you need will be given unto you, so that this day the Lord himself will do something unforgettable in your life. Talk to the Lord. Don't be too busy. Don't have your mind on activity, and you're not able to settle with the Lord. Settle it with the Lord right now.
Here on net will not be in vain. that we will walk, that we will pursue his kingdom, his righteousness, that we will not be busy in on earth here as a pilgrim doing nothing, that we will not be busy for nothing, that God will help us to be focused, that we should be busy in the right direction, that our soul will not be lost out of busyness, our children will not go astray because we have been out of business, that our families will not go astray out of business, that God will help us, that God will help us, that our soul will not be lost. There are trials, there are distractions. That God will help us to be wise. That God will help us to be wise. That God should help us to be wise. That God should help us to be wise. That God should help us to be wise. That we will be a good pilgrim. That our movement here on earth, our journey here on earth, it will be fruitful. It will be profitable. Pray that the word, oh God, that your life, that the word of God that we've heard, it will be profitable. We will not be like Gideon. We will not deviate. We will not abandon our vineyard like Gideon. We will not abandon our vineyard like Jeroboam. We will not abandon our vineyard like Solomon. That we will not be busy going here and there, here and there, without putting our family in the line of righteousness, without teaching our children the way of righteousness. Ask for the grace, for the wisdom to balance everything up, for the wisdom to walk in righteousness, for the wisdom as you are going on this journey, that the trials on the ways, the things of this world, the cares of this world, the busyness of this world will not take us away from the goal, will not take us away from the heavenly goal, will not take us away from our righteousness, will not make us to miss heaven, and our children will not miss heaven, that God will help us, that we will not be so busy, that we will not have the time for our families, that we will not have the time for our children, that we will not have the time for our own soul, that God will help us. Have we gone so busy? Have we gone so speed ahead? Have we forgotten that God is calling us back today? That God is calling us back today. That God will give us the wisdom, the wisdom, the wisdom. Father, give us wisdom. Lord, give me the wisdom, oh God. As a pilgrimage, oh God, on this earth. That my life will be profitable unto you. That I will not be busy taking care of the vineyards of others, why my own vineyard is unkept. I will not be busy. Help me, Father. I don't want that. I will not be busy chasing the things of this earth, busy here and there, and abandon my own soul. Lord, for it will profit me nothing if I gain the whole world and lose my soul. I refuse to exchange the riches of this earth. I refuse to exchange the activities of this world for my own soul. Lord, help me to keep my soul. I refuse, oh God, to achieve the things of this world and miss heaven. Well, I and my family, I and my children, I, oh God, and the church, oh God, that you have given unto us. Lord, give us the wisdom. Give us the wisdom that we will not miss heaven. That we will not miss heaven. That the race will not be run in vain. Lord of wisdom, Father. Lord of wisdom, Father. Lord of purity. Lord of power. Lord of power. Lord of power. The consecration. The sanctification. Lord, give unto me. Give unto us, O Lord. Call upon the Lord. Call upon the name of the Lord. Cry upon him. Cry upon the Lord this day. The power.